Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel again. Today we are going to be preparing Africa authentic suya. If today is your first time of passing by, please subscribe, press the red button below, subscribe, and don't forget to hit on the notification bell. Okay, so this is what we are going to be preparing today. You can see the beef that we have there. To prepare a suya, we need beef. And we also need the authentic suya pepper made by Team Melody Omo TV. So in case you have not watched this video, please go there and watch. Go to my channel and watch how to make that pepper. So we have salt, the oil, and the skewer, that is the stick meat or skewer. So what we need to do, we need to wash the beef meat. You have to wash it, and after washing, we'll be needing some kitchen towel to dry off the water. So make sure you remove the water from the beef. You see the kind of beef that we're using, no bone, and there is not too much fat. So any fat that is there, I'm going to remove every piece of it. Okay guys, so what we are going to be doing is we have to slice it out to be very very flat. Okay guys, so I'm just trying to look for a way. Okay, you can see, just cut it out like this. So let it be very flat the way you are going to be cutting it, and be very careful with your fingers guys, and don't get rid of your finger before you eat the suya meat. So try to just make it possible to be flat so that the cooking will be very easy and the spice can go inside thoroughly. So that is just it guys. So I'm just going to go ahead and make the slice of this meat, of this beef. So I want to use this opportunity to say thank you to every of my subscribers, old and new. I want to say thank you for always coming back to watch my videos. I pray that God bless you all in Jesus' name. So guys, that's just it. I just have to slice it up like this. Okay? So for all my subscribers, you are always welcome here, guys. You are always welcome here. So I have to show, this is another method. You can also cut the slice the meat so that you will not cut off the finger. So just do it like so. Hold the beef and slice it off. Okay, so now I'm going to insert it into the skewer or the stick meat. So just like this, just do it well, insert it into it like so. Okay guys, so I'm going to be doing about 2-3 and I will be doing the rest off camera. Just watch and see the way I do it. It's so easy guys. So this one, you need to be doing it at times in the weekend when you are at home with your family and enjoy life. Life is not all about taking a bad diet guys. Sometimes we need to enjoy it. That is just it guys. So just look at it the way I am doing it. So now I have finished inserting it into the skewer. You can see how beautiful it is and it's well done. So now I am going to be putting this spice, this suya spice or suya pepper, either way you know it or you call it, it's all the same. So first of all, I will have to sprinkle some salt in the meat before I begin to use the suya pepper on it. So without this spice, there is no suya. Normally it is that you can use this suya pepper on any meat. You can use it on your turkey, your chicken, or you can use it on grilled meat, and you can also use it on fried meat also, or fish. After cooking, just put it on top or use it to aroma is so super. The aroma in this spice, wow, it is so super. So just put it on in it like this, direct to the meat. And after all, we are going to be taking it to the oven, guys. It's a very easy process. Okay? So delicious. So it is done. Now I'm going to be putting it into the oven pan. But before I put it, I'm going to be putting the ash paper or the oven paper, the tray, for it not to stain the tray. Okay, and you can also put it directly with the tray and later you do the washing. But I prefer putting the wash paper. So just put it like this, arrange it properly on it. Okay, this suya is commonly eaten in West Africa. In the street, those days we buy them from the malam, we call them malam. So now you can make it in your home. Can enjoy it and even do it, the spice yourself. Those days, we just when you walk past them, you cannot go. You stand and begin to look how these people prepare it. Guys, it's so easy. So now I am going to be infusing the oil with the suya spice so that when the suya is half done, then we apply it on it. So just infuse it like this so that the oil will mix properly with the suya spice. Okay, guys, so just like this, so light, not too thick, then you can add some salt to it because of the oil. Okay, guys, so you can see I did not add any seasoning to it because the suya spice have everything together. So now I'm going to be adding my infused oil to the meat, almost half done. So you just use it to paint it like so, just do it like so and turn it over again and do the same process on it. So then take it to the oven and wait for about 20 to 25 minutes. And that is what I am going to be doing here. So then you can see the aroma in this kitchen. Our suya is ready. So now I am going to be presenting it properly to the house. Guys, it's so delicious. I can't wait, guys. So you could see I have sliced the tomatoes. Who can eat suya without tomatoes? Just slice the tomatoes like this. That is our suya that we made together, guys. It's so delicious. So now I put the suya into the plate. It's so easy and fresh, guys. So I think I will be inviting somebody to join us. And I don't know who to invite in this plate right away. So I invite everyone of you. Okay, join me. Okay, so now the brother or the family of this suya is onions, fresh onions. Just slice this on top and at the end of it, sprinkle some suya pepper on it. Guys, it's set to be eating. Wow, I'm so excited. I'm so happy to make this suya, guys. I always like to make it in my home, so I'm happy sharing it with you guys. So sprinkle some suya pepper on it. The suya is ready. Thank you so very much, my people, for watching my video. See you in my next video.